Complete Dominance, Part 2. Here we go. What if we take this woman here and this man here and cross them? What are the odds? What are the probabilities of getting different type children? Well, let's take a look, shall we? Here we go. Here's mom, big D, little d. She's heterozygous. Here's dad, big D, homozygous dominant. Let's take a look. If mom's here and dad is here, and again, we pull over all the possible combinations, D down here, D down here, D down here, D down here. These are all the possible combination of gametes that could come from this mom, right? She's either half or big D, half or little d, and dad, big D, big D. Well, what did we find? 1, 2, out of 1, 2, 3, 4 are big D, big D. 2 out of 4, which is the same as what? 1/2, 50%, right? 0.5. All of those can denote homozygous dominant. The probability from these two parents, from this mom and this dad, to get a homozygous dominant offspring is half. Half of their kids, by probability, should be homozygous dominant. What about the other half? One big D and one little d, one big D and one little d. Again, 2 out of 4, which is the same as saying 1/2, which is the same as saying 50%, which is the same as saying 0.5, will be big D, little d, or heterozygous. That's the probability from these two parents. And as you see, in this case, the dad's on top on this side, and the mom's over on this side. Does that matter? Who's on top? No, not for the Punnett Square, at least. If we put mom on top, or dad on the top, it doesn't change the outcome. Whether mom is the homozygous dominant and dad is the heterozygous doesn't change the outcome either. So in this case, we'll put mom back on the side because now she's big D, big D. And we'll put dad back on top because he's big D, little d, which is the opposite of how they were set up in the last one. And then we fill out this one also. D over, D's over, D's down, D's down. And what do we see? Yes, half big D, little d, half big D, big D. Regardless of which parent is the homozygote or the heterozygote, and regardless of which, if the heterozygote's on top or the homozygote is on top, like in the other one, it's the same exact thing. That, my friends, is the beauty of the Punnett Square. It does the math for you. It gives you the probability. You just have to fill out the stupid square, and there it is.